What's going on, guys? It's DJ Rick. Well, welcome back to week 3 now of Homecoming Madness. Rocking the DJ Life merch as always. First to arrive, last to leave. DJ Life sticker on the back of the truck as well. Anyways, we're at DJ Associates headquarters right now. Building number 1 down there. Building number 2. Building number 3. It's massive. But we're Chris is in here. I'm helping Chris out. We're loading up everything we need for Marietta High School's homecoming, which, if you guys remember, was massive last year.
I need to find that other. I got 3 things to find.
What we got?
It used to be handy here.
What are we looking for?
Another one of these.
For what?
Because we're gonna that hangs off the truss and we hang a mover on it, so it brings it down, so that gives it a better.
Oh, okay. Alrighty, we got the 18-foot trailer all loaded up, and we're ready to head on over to Marietta High School and get started on the setup. Anyways, he's going to be taking the trailer. I'm gonna be driving my truck over, and we'll get started unloading and setting up and doing all that fun stuff. Not as crazy a setup as what we did last year. Just a little bit more conservative for an easier setup and easier teardown. We are back at Marietta High School. You know, we do big stuff here. Big stuff. Anyways, Michelle already put up the pipe and drape, it looks like. And yeah, this is where we're gonna be setting up this year again. We're gonna be doing another 30 foot span of truss, except we're not gonna actually put it on legs. We're just gonna put it on crank stands. We're not gonna do the side hangs this year. You'll see, but I'm gonna go ahead and get my stuff and get loaded in here. In terms of equipment that I brought to this gig, it's very minimal.
So I got my SD case as always because I'm DJing. I got my 4 InnoSpot Pros. Yes, I don't have my road case because I didn't want to bring my trailer, and the road case was the only thing that wouldn't fit in the back of the truck. So I just brought them like this. I strapped these into the back of my my back seats, and the other 2 are in Ariba bags. We got my haze generator. We did get approval to use oil-based light haze. My cable bag for extra cables in case we need them. We shouldn't need any cables from there. And then we got my DJ bag, my jetpack bag with my laptop and everything else that we possibly will need. And then my camera bag and a cooler full of some drinks and snacks for today.
Chris is picking up lunch on his way over here for us. And when he gets here, we'll unload it and we'll start setting up. We're gonna be doing I already explained that. Making progress right now. I hooked up the audio for the most part. I mean, I have to go in the drive rack and tune it up, but we're got the subs laid down. Gonna hook up the amp rack in the back right now. Sound check, sound EQing, all that. Well, guys, a lot of time has passed. What is it, 5 o'clock? 5 o'clock-ish. So I wanted to take you guys on a full equipment tour of what all we're using. And yeah, I just completed sound check. It was absurdly loud. We'll do it again for the film so you guys can hear how distorted the camera audio is. So like we did at Meadowbrook and at Buckeye Trail, we'll go through our trussing and staging first, then we'll go into lighting, then we'll go into our audio. All right, so trussing and staging, staging. We have three 4x8 decks making a 12x8 stage. And then we have on the sides, we have 2 meter totems. That's like 6.5 feet. We have three meter sections, about 30 feet across the top. We're rocking the Pro X cranks that you guys have seen me use in the last 2 gigs. So here they are again. We're also using some T-truss, little T-extenders to bring these movers down on both sides. The trussing DJ stand that you guys have seen, if you guys didn't know, these are 1 meter legs. And then we have our box corner, and then we have two meters to stretch across the 12-foot stage. And again, we got the column and that. All right, so working our way back, we have movers. Our movers, we got 4 ADJ InnoSpot Pros. Those are mine. We got one there, one there, one there, and one there. And then up top, we have 4 Martin MH1 profiles. Par-wise, we're using pretty much all Blizzard pars. Actually, we are using all Blizzard pars. Everything up top is Hotbox EXAs. We got one in each corner for truss warming, and then we got 6 across the top. Then on the DJ, we have 2, one on below, one there, and 2 more over here doing the truss warming on the DJ console. And then we ran out of Hotbox EXAs and we're using Rockbox RGBWAs for the totems. And then we got my American DJ Haze generator. Sound wise, if you guys haven't heard yet, we're using 2 VRX 932 LAPs, JBL, and then 4 SRX 728s JBL as well. The SRX 728s are passive. We have the amp rack back here. And the amp rack, we are using 2 Crown Macrotech 9000i's, 1 for each pair. An interesting fact on the Macrotech 9000i's, we're pulling at peak volume about 14 to 15 amps per amp. So obviously these have their own dedicated circuits. There are drive racks in here. We're not using those drive racks. We're bypassing them and going straight into the amp from my drive rack. Up here, we have my console, which we have my HP Spectra X360 laptop running Serato, GTD audio wireless microphones below. Like I've said before, guys, this is the case build. There's plenty of videos on this case build, this amazing boom arm, everything that's down below, the DBX drive rack PA2, which is basically used to control everything. The router that's hooked up to this so that I can use the iPad to wirelessly tune the whole entire system. Pioneer DDJ SZ, all that fun stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That is all you guys really need to know in terms of that. We're using 5 different circuits throughout the room. There's one on each wall. On each wall, there's 2 behind here, and then there's 1 from up front that we're running a bunch of 10 gauge cable to get to back here to hook up the circuits. And everything's divided up perfectly fine. So. All right, that's your equipment tour, guys. I'm gonna do another sound check for you guys, as well as film some awesome lighting clips, and then we'll be getting to the gig. Interesting, at this homecoming, it's only 7:30 to 10 instead of the normal 8 to 11. So it's gonna be interesting to see how that plays out. I think that's gonna play in my favor to basically be able to speed mix a lot better. So basically the first hour, I'll speed mix. When I say speed mix, my speed mix is like a minute, 2 minutes, maybe 45 seconds per song. We'll do mostly a lot of the newer mumble rap and that sort of stuff with maybe a little bit of remixes in there for the first hour. And then the second hour, I'm gonna try and kick it up and do a little bit of EDM, go back to maybe some more of the mumble rap in between there, maybe some remixes, some bootlegs. And then we will finish up with the closer. If you guys didn't know, I started to the point where I posted a few of my full playlist sets on Instagram. So follow me on Instagram. You can see Metabricks playlist. I played like 97 songs or something like that in that time span. It's on there, and I'll definitely put this one up afterwards as well on my Serato history. Austin is finishing his lighting back there. Oh, I didn't even talk about the lighting software we're using. We got a lighting board back here. If I didn't mention, all this is DJ Associates stuff. I found out Tuesday that I was doing this gig. So what we got here, Austin?
The Champsys MQ80.
There you go. Fancy DMXing stuff that I've never got into. Austin doesn't even know what he's doing. He's just pushing buttons. Alrighty, guys, it's 6:43 right now. I'm gonna go change, and then we'll do one last sound check, and then it's go time. We'll be right back. 7:15 and they're already letting them in. I hate the schools let them in early. I hate that they show up early. Why? Why are you showing up early? Why? There's no point. You're just gonna stand there. Anyways, I got actually mixed now for a little bit, even though they don't start yet, so we'll see. Alrighty, geek time.
Yo, what's up?
I got good footage there. That was nuts. I really dig this new 7:30 to 10 stuff. It was dope. I could play like literally all hits. That was great. I loved it. Anyways, we are completely done. Look at all this trash. It's not that bad. Imagine if we would have had foam sticks. Holy crap, that would have been crazy. Anyways, me and Austin are gonna get started on tearing down what we can because we were the first homecoming done. I don't think we have much to tear down. This should only take me and Austin maybe 2 hours, but if we get more people to come and help, it'll be about an hour. This one was close to being the most lit one I did. Meadowbrook was lit. This one was also lit. Mad compliments though from both the kids getting high fives and all the administration. They loved it. We'll wrap it up though after potentially having time lapses, or I'll just show you at the end that it's tore down. It is 12:30 and we are completely tore down. 2.5 hours as far as what we're doing. The rest of this stuff will get tore down tomorrow. All the stuff's in the corner. Chris will pick that up tomorrow. But we're out of here. We're done. So I will wrap up this video at a later date. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was crazy. This gig log was absolutely stupid insane, and it's also super long, so I'm gonna spare you guys the misery. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, leave it down in the comment section down below. If you're not already subscribed to this YouTube channel, be sure to click that subscribe button. And like always, guys, my name is DJ Rick Webb. Keep them records spinning, and I will see you guys next time with an amazing, awesome, lit gig log. Peace.